Kat and Paula Waters love riding their horses, Bramble and Hoot, and their walk Monday brought an extra treat, crossing West Windsor, Vermont's brand new covered bridge.
Not having it around actually was surprisingly debilitating.
The Bowers Bridge was battered by Tropical Storm Irene in August of last year. The raging Mill Brook tore the nearly 130-year-old structure from its abutments. A YouTube user documented the aftermath.
This is really sad.
The racing floodwaters dropped the bridge upright, amazingly, about 200 yards downstream.
You'll never see that again.
Hopefully not.
Select Board Chair Glenn Seward says his small town never seems to consider anything but a new covered bridge.
This bridge is near and dear to many people in West Windsor.
$250,000, mostly insurance money and federal funds, got the Bowers Bridge back up just before the anniversary of the flood. It's fairly short by most standards and only wide enough for one car at a time, but it still fills you with a huge sense of history.
I looked at it as being probably the only opportunity to do a covered bridge.
Steve Bodley is the timber framer behind the project. He spent months recreating the structure, but was able to salvage some original pieces, including key support arches.
Built to last.
A handful of other Vermont communities also lost covered bridges to Irene's fury, and nearly a year after the storm, work on replacing those bridges continues.
And in case this tiny brook ever rises again, the new Bowers Bridge is 18 inches higher than its predecessor. Good news for Kat and Paula Waters and all the others who rely on the span to get around.